All right, so how do you secure two boys with the current right ahead of you? All right, so you can see that I have shown the position of the current in the figure, and I've shown you the initial position of the ship as position number one, and the final position of the ship as position number two. There are two buoys, of course. This is the stern buoy, which is made fast to the ship's stern, and this, of course, is the head buoy, which is made fast to the vessel's bow. All right, so at position number one, you can see that the vessel is approaching the head buoy under slow headway. So maybe the ship is on slow ahead, or maybe dead slow ahead over the ground, with the head buoy is fine on the ship's port bow, at position number one. That's clearly shown. All right, and then what will happen is that the line is secured initially to the head buoy. So the ship will pass a line and secure it to the head buoy first. Here the engine must still be working slow ahead, and the reason is because we are assuming here that the vessel is on a right-handed propeller, and if you work the engine slow ahead, you can use the principles of transverse thrust to swing the vessel's bow to port. But it has to be a controlled swing. If you go at more speed than a dead slow ahead or slow ahead, it will become difficult to control the momentum of the swing, and that's why you have to go at slow ahead enough to give it a steerage, but at the same time to be able to cant the bow towards the port bow. Now, with the buoy situated on the port bow, the effect of the transverse thrust is favorable. Like I explained before, so right-handed propellers ahead movement, the vessel's bow will start to swing to the port. So the vessel is then allowed to drop downstream so that the stern buoy can be picked up. All right, so then slowly the vessel's momentum is arrested, and you can use a slow stern movements to go towards the stern buoy and secure the vessel. Because the vessel will be fastened to the head buoy, it will be easier for you to manage the vessel's direction towards the stern buoy. Now, if I change the direction of the current to a stern current, and again, like I said, it's easier to handle the ship with the current coming from ahead, because it helps in the checking of the speed, and the current also provides some resistance. It's much easier. It gets a bit trickier with the current astern, because here the current is actually pushing the vessel, the speed becomes more, so it's sometimes difficult to control the momentum of the vessel. But anyhow, I've shown you the three positions of the vessel as it comes to the buoys. The buoy here is, of course, the head buoy, which is finally made fast to the vessel's bow, and here is, of course, the stern buoy, which is made fast to the vessel's stern. And the three positions of the vessels are shown here. The current is coming from a stern, but we have to swing the vessel in such a way that we face the current in the final position. So that's why the vessel will secure to the first buoy on her port bow at position one. So at position one, approach the buoy at the slowest speed at which the steering can be maintained. And again, we are assuming this is a right-handed propeller ship where ahead movement will cant the bow to port, and you pass a line to the port buoy and you fasten a line there. As soon as you fasten a line there, then again it becomes easier for you to control the steerage of the vessel, and using the ship's movement, you can then slowly turn the vessel around. So the vessel will then, having been given a slight cant to port, like I mentioned before, allow the current to carry her round to position number two and three, because the current is pushing. You can see in the diagram itself in which direction the current is coming in. So the current will be pushing you anyway. So as you start to swing, and you can use a bit of the ship's engine's movement as well, to make sure that the vessel cants in your favorite direction to port as you give a head movement. And as the vessel is being pushed by the current and using the engines, and you are pulling on the line which is made fast to the buoy, the vessel will start to turn towards position two and three. And then once she is beam on to the stream, that is the tidal streams we are talking about, the direction of the tidal current becomes beam on, it's exactly acting on your beam, your ship's engines should be worked slow ahead with port helm to relieve the stress on the headline. So what will happen is, when the current is acting on the port beam, you are giving engine movements as well, and you are pulling and you are giving a helm, so the vessel will easily then turn to port, like I mentioned before, using the principles of transverse thrust. And at this particular instance, the buoy could be very well having been picked up on the starboard bow. So again, you can then pass the line on to the stern buoy at position 2 itself. You can pass the line to the stern buoy, make fast to that, and then with two lines fast to the vessel, it will become easier for you to control the steerage of the vessel and then use the engine movements appropriately to bring the ships to the appropriate position. All right, thanks guys, I'll see you soon with my next video. Bye for now.